Hi Sunshine, welcome back to my channel. If you're a returning subscriber, what's up? I hope you had an amazing week and November is starting amazingly for you. I hope everything is fine and all that. And if you're not a subscriber, you're new to my channel, my name is Monde Kituma. I shoot amazing things on amazing topics, many videos. Just click here to see my trailer and, you know, feel free to join the Sunshine family. There's always space for anyone. So today, I want us to do now part two of the four-part series in the toxic work environment. So today, I want us to talk about what not to tell someone who is currently in a toxic work environment. Be it your friend, your family member, your husband, your acquaintance, your neighbor. These are the things that you should not tell that person who is currently in a toxic work environment. So as usual, let's go straight to the video.
I can't think nothing better than spending my day with you. My life's sunny and better.
In my previous video, if you haven't watched, you can just click here. I talked about characteristics and signs of toxic workplaces, and I decided to move now to the next part of that toxic workplace series, what not to tell someone who is currently in a toxic workplace. So the first thing that I would let you know as a friend or a family member or a neighbor or a cousin or an acquaintance of someone in a toxic workplace, the first thing you should not tell them is, ask them the question of, what have you done? Like, what did you do wrong? You know, the reason I'm saying this is most of the times, I think 90% of the time or even 100% of the time, toxic workplaces are toxic not because of what employees are doing, but what is happening in the top level management or what the organization culture is in that particular organization. So you'll find someone joins the organization with high hopes, someone comes in with new fresh ideas, comes in with experience, comes in with the aspect of bringing change, and then this environment comes and messes them up, tears them down. Either it's a top level management or your direct supervisor who will tear you down, make the environment not conducive, make other employees also not very comfortable. So it has nothing to do with the employee. It's not their performance, it's not what they've done, it's not how they work, it's not what they wear, it's not how they talk. It's nothing to do with this particular employee. So as a friend or an acquaintance or a family member, asking this particular person who's now shared their toxic work environment story with you shifts the blame from what is happening to them, and now it makes them look like they're the catalyst. So that is not right. So please don't ask them a question, because it is not their fault. It's not something they're doing. It's something that is happening to them. So that's number one. Number two, tell them how lucky they are to have a job. I don't know if it's an African thing, but most of the time when you complain or you air your views on challenges that you're facing, most of the time people tell you how lucky you are first. You know, you should be grateful you have a job. That's the first thing people tell you. You should be grateful you have a job. I've been looking for a job for 5 years. My niece has been looking for a job for 7 years. If I had the job, I would do it so well. Oh, you know, you're not grateful. Oh, you know, you're very lucky. You know, if I just had that opportunity. And people don't sit down and take a step back and just listen to what this person is talking about. They're not saying they're ungrateful for having a job. No, they're very grateful. They're just airing how uncomfortable they are in that particular work environment. So please don't tell them they're lucky to have a job. They know the importance of that job. They know how hard they work to get that job. They know how hard they work in that particular job. So you bringing in the aspect of them not being grateful now starts messing with their mind. They start, you know, this one's for like, am I really, really, is this environment really bad, or am I overreacting? Am I only looking for the bad things in the work? Like, it may lead these people into a downward spiral that they don't deserve to go through, because trust me, they're already going through a lot of stuff. So they don't need this added, you know, guilt tripping from people outside. So please don't tell them they're lucky to have a job. They know they are not lucky. They are qualified and they have worked hard to get that job. So that's number two. Number three, please don't make them feel guilty. You know, the songs for you share with someone, they're certainly, you know, you're always so negative. You know, you're always looking for the bad things in everything. Why can't you see the positive? These people are paying you so much money. They're giving you opportunities. They're giving you amazing allowances. There's room for growth, but they do not understand the nitty gritty of the toxic work environment. Your growth may be stunted. Yes, maybe they started you the high salary, but that's it. But that money they're giving you, you have to pay for it. You know, when they say pay for it, when you're sick, you still have to work. During the weekend, you still have to work. Leave days don't exist. There's no time for lunch. Like, you have to pay for that money. So these people know where to get you. So when someone shares this and then you start making them feel guilty because they are sharing what they're going through, or you start telling them the songs for, you know, you're too sensitive, you know, in the outside world, you need to toughen up, and you know, you're taking to, you know, the best song, you're taking things to heart. What is it called? You're taking things personally. It's not personal, you know, it's just a business, how it's supposed to be working. Stop guilt tripping these people. I assure you, someone who's been in a toxic workplace, I have been in one. By the time I got to the point of sharing my story, I knew it had nothing to do with me now. It was not me. It was everything around me that was making it not work. And then now when someone tries to turn the story and make you feel, imagine apana tulia, you now start doubting yourself and spiraling, and you stay in that toxic work environment as opposed to looking for opportunities to leave and go on. So that's the third thing you should not tell them. Number four, please, please, for the sake, I don't know how to say it, stop comparing the situation with others. You know, this one's for, is it, you tell someone a story, then they try to tell you a story that's worse than theirs. You know, you're like, you know, guys, us guys don't have lunch. I'm like, I even have to work until Saturday the evening. I'm like, therefore, thus, it's fine, but you're not listening to the situation that this person in the toxic work environment is going through. So I would urge you, stop comparing them. Stop telling them how your daughter in so-and-so company is struggling more, or how you, when you started working out, you struggled and you had to go through so many things and eventually you made it. Stop comparing the situation and your situation, because number one, no two human beings are the same. Even twins, identical twins, have different personalities. The environment is different. The time is different. You are not in that particular, like, you're not, what is the word? You're not there. You're not in their shoes. You have not lived a life, a day in their life to experience what they're experiencing. So stop comparing. And I remember there's something I had from a lady called Jeannie Bai. She was asking, if you have a flower and the flower does not grow in your, like, you have a flower in your garden and it's not growing, do you blame the flower or do you move the flower from that part of the garden to another part of the garden? And that made me really think. And I was like, stop comparing. Stop telling this flower you're not growing because, oh, this hasn't been done, this and that. Maybe the soil might not be working out. So that's another thing. And the other one, gaslighting them. So when you talk about gaslighting, people think it's something so big and so major, like it's a big word, so it has to be done in a big circumstance. I'm like, not really. Gaslighting is when someone shares something and now you turn the story and make them feel like, hey, you don't know what you're saying. So it's also for, they open up to you as a friend or as their family member or their acquaintance or their mentor. You're their mentor. They open up to you. And then I start making them feel like, hey, whatever they're saying, no. That's how it's supposed to be. Like, you know, you're seeing your own things. You're feeling your own things. Or sounds for like, hey, that one you misinterpreted. This person has, no, those are especially people who've just left campus and they're starting and they'll be told, no, this person is trying to mentor you, is trying to build you. I think you misunderstood the situation. No. It's not like that. To the point that these people even start doubting your own experience. You start doubting your own experiences because someone is telling you, no. Imagine, no, then now they even change the situation. It's more of what have you done? What have you been doing wrong? What do you need to improve on yourself for you to be able to work in that toxic work environment? And that is not true, because it's not you. It is not you. It has never been you. It will never be you. It has never, like, you have never done anything wrong to warrant this behavior. And lastly, the one that I found that people shared was, people tell you it's a rite of passage, like you need to work for a bad boss or a bad company because it builds your character, it makes you strong, makes you understand how the real world is, it gives you one-on-one coaching and mentorship, it helps you to be able to work in any situation. If you've gone through a bad employer, you can work anywhere and you'll be fine. And I'm like, No, you don't have to go through a bad employer or a toxic work environment for you to be able to develop a strong character or for you to be able to transition from campus to the real world, if that's what you want to call, because campus is virtual reality. No, but campus is the real world. The thing you need to understand, for every particular stage in life, the real world changes. So now moving from campus to working, that's a transition. And you can transition from campus and go work in a good working environment, which demands, you know, a good working environment demands a lot from you, but within the boundaries that they had been set in the contract that you signed, and rewards you so well for that. Like, you even feel, I'm not saying you feel like you're at home, but you feel like you want to go to work, you have new ideas you want to try, you're motivated, you're rewarded, your grievances are heard and such. So you don't have to go through a toxic work environment to build your character, or it's not a rite of passage. And I remember my former boss had told me, you know, I went through this and see how well it turned out. And I'm like, no, you didn't turn out well, because if it turned out well, you would not be doing that to the next person. It's just once for, you're just transferring pain from you and transferring it to the next person. So no. Please, you don't have to go through a bad toxic work environment as a first job because it's a rite of passage. So please stop telling them it's a rite of passage. That is it. Let me know, is there anything else I have forgotten in the things you should not tell someone in a toxic work environment? Let me know down below. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you now in my next video. There are like 2 more videos on this toxic work series. Let me know if they're interesting to you. Let me know if they make sense to you. Let me know if you've been in this toxic work environment. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video, share, and subscribe if you haven't. I'll see you in part 3 of the toxic work environment. Bye.